Hi there, I'm Helen Mabel, I'm an artist, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can start an Etsy sticker shop for under $100. Starting an Etsy shop has become really popular lately, especially sticker shops. There's so many videos on YouTube and TikTok of people showing off their shops, and it can look pretty daunting sometimes, especially if you don't know where to start or if you don't want to spend a lot of money. Last summer, I decided to start my own sticker shop because I am an artist and I just thought it would be so much fun to sell my own design. But I'm also a college student, so I don't just have a ton of money to be throwing around. It is possible though to start an Etsy sticker shop on a budget, and today I've created a list of supplies that you will need to start your own shop. All the products and materials that I will be talking about today will be linked in the description below, and I will also be leaving a link to my previous video that I did on starting my own Etsy sticker shop. All right, let's get into it. First things first, you are going to need sticker paper. I recommend getting vinyl sticker paper or something similar to start off with. The sticker niche on Etsy is highly competitive, so if you start off with a really low quality sticker paper, you might not get very many sales. To be fair, I did start off with a very low quality sticker paper myself, but now I am transitioning into a vinyl sticker paper because it'll just hold up a lot better and it is water resistant, which is a great selling point. The vinyl sticker paper that I got is for inkjet printers and it is waterproof and tear resistant, and it is $13 for 25 sheets. So just a little less than $2 per sheet. 25 sheets may not seem like a lot, but it is a good place to start, and you'd be surprised how many stickers you can fit onto a single page. Moving on to thank you cards. With every order you pack, you should include a thank you card. This makes your buyer feel special when they open their package from you, and you can include all sorts of things on the card to encourage your buyer to purchase from your shop again in the future. I recommend using cardstock paper for your thank you cards because they will just feel so much more professional than using copy paper or regular printer paper. This pack of white cardstock by AstroBrights contains 75 sheets of paper and costs only $7. I also think having white cardstock is really handy for lots of other things, and you'll be surprised how much you end up using it. You could use it to start making art prints or bookmarks, and it could also be used as a white backdrop for your photos or even to create a bounce light. I also want to include that this budget does not include purchasing a printer. You can't really get a new printer for much less than $100 on its own. If you don't have a printer and you can't really afford to buy one right now, you could look into getting one secondhand from somewhere like Facebook Marketplace, or you could ask a friend or neighbor if you could borrow theirs and maybe pay them back for ink usage, or you could even possibly print at your local library. That being said, if you do have a printer, you're going to need ink, and ink can be expensive. I have an HP printer, and HP actually has a program called HP Instant Ink, and it is really great if you're using your printer often and using large amounts of ink per page. I'm currently signed up for a plan that costs $5 a month and allows me to print up to 100 pages, and I can use as much ink on those 100 pages as I want, and HP will just send me new ink whenever I am low at no additional cost. If you go over the page limit, then you do have to pay a little extra, but they have multiple plans with different amounts of pages, the first one starting at just 99 cents a month. If you are going to run a sticker shop, you are going to need to cut your stickers somehow. Now, a budget of $100 doesn't really allow you to get a cutting machine, but if you can afford it, I highly recommend it because it saves you so much time. Cricut just released a new version of their cutting machine, and I have noticed that a lot of people are selling their old versions so that they can get the new one. Facebook Marketplace is a great place to look for something like that, and I bet you could find a great deal or maybe bargain with someone to get a Cricut Explore Air 2 for around $100. I got my Cricut Explore 1 machine for $80 from someone on Facebook. She only used it once or twice and it was in great condition. She still had the box and everything, and I got it for $80. I think that was a pretty good deal. Anyway, moving back on to the affordable cutting options, I recommend that every shop owner get a paper cutter. This one is only $10 from Amazon, and it saves a lot of time when you're cutting out thank you cards, or if you decide to make art prints, or just something else that requires straight edges. It can also come in handy if you ever need to cut packing supplies. It is not an absolute necessity for running a sticker shop, but I think it's a good investment for just $10. You are also going to want a good pair of scissors. I know most of you probably already have a few pairs of scissors lying around your home, but it is good to invest in a pair of new and nicer scissors if you plan on cutting out your stickers by hand with scissors. This 2-pack of scissors on Amazon is what I purchased, and I'm glad I went with a 2-pack because I'm always misplacing at least one while working. This pack is $8, but really any pair of scissors will do. You could just pick some up the next time you're at the store. Just avoid getting like the super cheap ones that are only a dollar or two. Another option for cutting out your stickers is using an X-Acto knife. I find this to be an easier option for cutting out stickers by hand because I just feel more comfortable using a knife, and then I don't have to worry about like bending the sticker while trying to use the scissors to cut it. It's really a personal preference whether you like using an X-Acto knife or scissors, but this X-Acto knife on Amazon is only $6 and it has a ton of positive reviews. Replacement blades are also pretty cheap. Now, if hand cutting your scissors isn't really the route you want to go down, you could get something like a circle punch. This is what I started out with because I really just didn't want to spend hours cutting out my stickers by hand. Just keep in mind that these types of punches aren't always perfect, so you might need to clean up the edges of your stickers a little bit. There are so many different options for shapes and sizes of punches, and you can try to plan your sticker designs around the type of punch you get so that it looks like a design choice. I went with this 2-inch circle punch, which I feel like is a good size for a sticker, and it was $12. All right, now that you've got everything you need to make your stickers, let's move on to packing supplies. Woo-hoo. You're gonna need something to ship your stickers in. I got these bubble mailers in a pack of 50 for $7, which is a pretty good deal. Some also have really cute patterns, like these little flower ones. They're just so cute. There are a ton of different sizes and colors of these on Amazon, but I went with these 4x8 peach colored ones to match the aesthetic of my shop. I also ended up getting a 25 pack of these larger mailers for when I ship art prints because the inside of the 4x8 mailers isn't quite large enough. Bubble mailers are a really good option for starting your sticker shop because they are waterproof and they keep your stickers from bending too much. As your shop grows, you might want to invest in rigid mailers or a different kind of mailer. There are a couple different options for how you package your stickers before you actually put them in the mailers. I do a combination of cellophane bags and tissue paper. I put my stickers in cellophane bags to keep them from getting wet, and then I wrap up everything in tissue paper to make it easy to slide into the mailers. I got a pack of 100 3x4 cellophane bags for just $5, and I just picked up some tissue paper from the dollar store, but you can also get a bulk pack from Amazon for $7. When I eventually run out of the cellophane bags, I'm going to switch over to glassine bags because they are more environmentally friendly. A pack of 100 glassine bags is only a few dollars more at around $8. I definitely recommend that you put your stickers in some sort of bag rather than just wrapping them in tissue paper because it does add that extra layer of protection that keeps them from getting wet from things like rain or snow or other wet things. Now, before you send your stickers off into the world, you will need to weigh them. Usually stickers are very lightweight and don't add any cost to shipping, but Etsy does require the weight of your products and packaging materials if you want to print your shipping labels through them. Really all you need for this is a simple kitchen scale. If you don't already have one, you can find this one for $12 on Amazon and it will certainly do the job. Speaking of shipping, I often get a lot of questions about shipping and shipping prices. Etsy actually has an option for printing shipping labels through the site so that you aren't actually the one paying for shipping. Once you have your weights of your products entered in, Etsy will calculate the cost of shipping and then charge your buyer for shipping at checkout. You can also just pay for shipping yourself and work it into the prices of your products, but I find the other option to be much easier. And finally, there are fees on Etsy when you decide to start a shop. Etsy charges you 20 cents per listing, and this will last you 4 months before you have to pay this again to keep your listing active. Personally, I don't think that's a whole lot, especially if you are only starting off with a few products. You'll want to keep in mind that Etsy does take a percentage of your earnings. Etsy takes a 5% transaction fee for every sale that you make. All right, so if we add up everything that I have suggested, including the $5 towards the HP Instant Ink subscription, we end up coming in with a grand total of $95. You can start an entire small business with just $95. Or even less than that if you decide that some of the things that I suggested aren't necessary, because what you get and how you run your shop is entirely up to you. These are just all my suggestions based on my own experience and budget. Really, the only other cost is going to be your time. It takes a lot of time and a lot of patience to start a shop, and it is not easy. Making your products, taking photos, uploading your listings, it can all take a lot of time, but it also can be really worth it in the end. I hope that you found this video helpful and that it can help you to get your sticker shop started. Again, everything that I mentioned today will be linked down below in the description. Let me know if you have any questions or if you have any suggestions for future videos like this one that you would like to see from me. Subscribe if you want to see more creative content from me, and follow me over on Instagram and TikTok at HelenMabelMakes if you want to see some sneak peeks of upcoming content. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.